Will you send people who live in religion to be stoned? Should be killed or not?
Should be stoned.
They should be stoned.
My script was to show that the Lord of Muhammad, one of the gods you worship, is Jibril, because he's sitting on the throne of Allah.
Where's the throne? Who's sitting on them?
In the throne.
Everyone sits on his own throne. So God is not the only one.
Doesn't Elizabeth sit on her throne?
We're not talking about humans.
Muslims worship more than one god. Tawheed means unification. So Jibril is on the throne of Allah, one god. Allah is another god. And the Kaaba stone is another god. They are polytheists.
Brother. Kill those who believe in other gods.
This is your Bible.
Deuteronomy 17:25.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Her Bible.
You want an answer?
Her Bible.
My question.
Her Bible.
What does Islam teach?
Suppose a man or a woman among you in one of your town that the Lord, your God, is giving you has done evil.
I'm reading from a commentary on YouTube.
No.
Yes, you are.
No.
Where are you? Where are you?
You are
on YouTube.
Yeah.
Answering about the
I'm giving you verse.
We asked you about.
I'm giving you verse.
We asked you about a prophecy.
I'm giving you a reference.
Why we command your
kill those who believe in other gods.
Thank you very much.
The problem with you.
YouTube. He's on YouTube.
I'm giving you verse.
No, you're not.
David,
Deuteronomy 17:25.
Yes,
Deuteronomy.
You're escaping. Answer it.
So do not take from among them any of
kill all who disbelieve in Jesus.
But if they
follow him through the city and kill everyone whose forehead is not marked.
Sir, am I right to understand? According to Islam, people who live the religion of Islam,
Ezekiel 9:5. I think the same. Who doesn't believe in Jesus?
There
you go.
Why are you running away from the Bible? Why are you running away from the Quran? We're not running away.
We are
confronting you first. We will. One by one. One by one. Answer her question. Answer her question.
Ezekiel, come on, open.
Okay, again.
Open Ezekiel.
Liar.
We don't want to.
When we give you about the Quran, you shout and holler as if we're saying something wrong.
Calm down. One by one, we'll deal with it.
Okay.
Kill the blasphemer.
So you're not interested.
Take the blasphemer outside the camp and tell all those who heard him to lay their hands on his head.
Thank you.
Let entire community stone him to death.
Thank you very much.
This is Leviticus 24:10.
Thank you.
It's funny that you're quoting verses.
Their Bible. Yeah,
Christians.
Their Bible says.
Hello.
Thank you.
Stop drinking camel piss.
What?
Stop drinking camel pee.
Hello? See, he doesn't want the answer. That's the problem with him. He doesn't want the answer.
And he, she comes and tells us.
What did Jesus say to us? What did Jesus say to us?
Get lost from here.
He doesn't want
it. Should Rahaf Muhammad be killed?
Exactly. Answer question. Should Rahaf Muhammad be killed? Do you know Rahaf Muhammad? Do you know Rahaf Muhammad?
Who the hell is
you're
he?
Turning around now. Yeah, look at you. You're running away.
Who the hell she is?
You don't know who Rahaf Muhammad is?
How do I know who she is?
Exactly.
Good for her. If she left, she left.
Killed her.
What do you want me to do?
Said,
have you I don't know.
Thailand. And Jesus said, I'm not going to tell you.
Allow it, bro. Allow it, man.
I do not. Man. Big man. I do not.
I don't consent.
Big man. Big man.
She should be accountable for whether she gets killed or not.
What is the punishment for her if she's accountable for it? What is the punishment? Is it punishment having hot chocolate with your father or your religious leader? Or the punishment, let's get it off your head. What is the punishment?
The punishment is that the Sharia law will account for the Sharia law, basically, in the Sharia law, it's like the public head. So we have court people who provide witnesses and stuff. Yeah? So this girl, I believe she shouldn't be killed because at the end of the day, this is what they say, that anyone has a choice when it comes to religion. Let her be. No one has compulsion or religion. If she wants to leave Islam, that is totally up to her. No one should kill her. And if anyone kills her, I condemn it. And all of us condemn it.
So let me respond so far what you said. So far, all I am understanding is you don't think she should be killed.
No, she shouldn't.
So am I right to understand you are apostate by yourself too? Because you just sit the band against the teachings of the Quran and against the teachings of the Hadith.
No.
So, Surah 4, first line you
tell me what Surah 4 says.
And also, how did I'm going to bring it to you?
Did you have context? When I worship someone else, did you have the context?
I'll read the verse for you. Check up your phone up and then give me what it's supposed to say. Okay? David, you should disbelieve as they disbelieve. So you would be alive. So do not take from among the aliens until they immigrate for the cause of Allah. But if they turn away, if they refuse, then seize them and kill them. So, am I right to say you think Surah 4 verse 89 is not relevant to us today? It is not relevant to 498. It is not relevant.
Surah 498.
It is not relevant to Rahaf Muhammad.
Can you read a few more verses before that?
Open your phone up, sir.
No,
I gave you the verse. You open
it.
You know that intention doesn't work with me, guys.
It will show you wonders,
and it
gives you a sign and a wonder.
It doesn't matter.
And the sign of wonders comes to pass.
How are you?
Let us
I embrace Jesus Christ.
No, I do.
Can you read this Arabic verse? Let me just take up the Arabic version to make sure you are reading the right Arabic.
I embrace this Christ, my brother.
Again, baby. He's a little coward. He's a little coward. Baby, who had his faith? No manners.
I will pray for servants. And I pray for you.
I will pray for God.
You
will come
back. No, I'll pray for you. Do not pray.
Oh,
I know you get tricked.
Yes, the next bus. Oh, how can you be
honest?
You didn't
give us the next bus. I know you want to kill me. I'm making this bus. I know you want to kill me. I know that.
Okay, so the question for this bus, Hatton, is except for those who take refuge in the duties of yourself, and which is a treaty of those who come to you, the heart stay there, fighting you or fighting their own people. Now, this girl, he's a so-called apostate. Is she fighting the government, the Sharia government?
So that's what I was asking for my question.
Is she fighting the Sharia government? Yes or no?
Didn't she already dishonored her family, already dishonored her government, and the Islam, and the Muhammad, and the Quran?
She's not fighting them.
By sitting silent and denying Islam.
Help him.
I'm here.
I know what the verse says. I know what it says. This girl, if she was going to cause a revolution towards the Sharia law, if she was going to cause a revolt, you know what a revolt is? When she stands up against the Sharia law and she was going to cause war, then she would be killed in the form of war. But the verse says,
show me the verse, sir. That is your wonderful interpretation. It looks like you are just telling me. Sadly, another day, Allah couldn't communicate.
Except for those who take refuge with their people to be yourself, him is a Jew. But those who come to you,
how long have you been Muslim?
My whole life.
Your whole life? Are you over 18?
20.
So, can you just tell me, in your 20 years of Muslim life, you never bothered to look at the Surah 9 verse 29 and then read the statement?
I'm not
Surah 4, 90 has been abrogated by Surah 9, 29.
You need evidence for that.
Read Ibn Kathir for the Surah 9.
No, but we don't all accept Ibn Kathir though.
Why is Ibn Kathir daif? Sir, don't play
some
that
of it
jumping.
Is, yes, some of it is.
Ibn Kathir is a tafsir, there is no daif in it, sir. You don't even know the basics.
What do you mean?
Allah tells us Surah 4, verse 90 has been abrogated by Surah 9, verse 29. Therefore, you cannot use the Surah 9 for Surah 490. Why did you stand against Islam and say because she's apostate, she shouldn't be killed?
No, she will only be killed if she called a revolt, a revolution, in a state
of war.
But
doesn't say that.
It says it here, except for those who don't try to fight you.
Sir, I already told you that verse has been abrogated.
Now you need evidence for that.
I am already telling you evidence. Ibn Kathir, Surah 9, verse 29.
What
did you say there? What did you say there? Arabic?
Kill
the people who don't believe in God.
Is it possible?
They would have fought you. So if they remove themselves from you, do not fight you, offer you peace.
Yeah, this is kafar.
That's what it says.
Kufar people. Non-believers. As you lot. Non-believers.
No, you're refuted.
Non-believers. It's not you. You're Ahlul Kitab. It's non-believers. He's talking about.
Sir.
Non-believers.
Just a walk away. Because no answer.
He's got an answer. Allow him.
Yes, this is non-believers, not them. These people are Ahlul Kitab. We respect them.
Sir, I'm asking a simple question.
Yes, what are you asking?
This speak. Have you heard this beautiful lady called Rahaf Mohammed?
Who's Rahaf Mohammed?
She's Murtad. You never looked at the news district, but
I'm living in Halsden. That's
so, even in Halsden, there is television. So, there is a lady called Rahaf Mohammed.
What show is it?
Beautiful woman, yes. 18 years old.
By the way,
only her disadvantages, she was from Saudi Arabia. She decided this book is a false book.
That's hesitation.
And Mohammed is a false prophet.
No.
And she seeks asylum because she becomes an apostate.
That's her decision. You can't do nothing. You can make your own decision.
Can you show me any verse from the
Don't put it in the camera, man.
No, that's
the verse from the Quran tells you when someone is the religion of Islam, father and family should have a hot chocolate with her and lots of sweets with her.
Be honest and answer, honestly.
Sharia court judges should have a hot chocolate with her. So what does Islam teach about the apostate?
Murtad. We call that Murtad. Murtad is people are... when you leave Islam, you call them Murtad. Now you are against Islam. Now you leave Islam, you choose another religion, we call them Murtad. Now they're non-believers.
So everyone who lives in Islam, they are identified as non-believers who are against Islam because they rejected the Islam.
But you're a Muslim, don't you?
What do you
if
do
I was a Christian,
that?
Same thing you would do
what
to me.
What do you do
with
what
that? I am a Christian.
Sir, just answer my question. I'm going to answer your question.
I'm kafir with Christianity and is kafir in my religion.
I am going to answer your question.
Come on.
YouTube. I don't believe
you. Vaping. Look at that little coward. Look at that. Vaping like a little coward. That's all you got, bro.
If a Shia woman leaves the religion of Islam, decides from now on, Quran is a false book and Muhammad is a false
book. If you leave Islam, are they going to kill you?
Bro!
Listen, I'm going to see his view and my view because I'm a different from Islam. Because his guy is different. His guy is different.
Sir, no worries. I will treat you as a Shia Muslim.
Yeah, and this guy
even
is
though Muslim. They, behind the okay. cameras, they tell you they are kafir, they should kill you. But that's different thing. I heard the conversation. They were making these claims about the Shia.
Okay.
Anybody who says La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah is a Muslim.
I am with you.
Okay. I'm saying Muhammad is a false prophet. Allah is false God. And Lord Jesus Christ is God. So, what should happen to people who leave the religion of
Islam? If you leave Islam, that's your own decision. As a Shia view, if you leave Islam, no jokes here. If you leave Islam, that's your own decision. I don't know about the other side of Islam. Yeah, that's your decision if you leave Islam. That's it. We do nothing to you. You make your own decision. You live Islam. We call them Murtad. Murtad means, Murtad.
Is it?
What's Murtad in English?
Murtad means a bad Muslim.
A bad Muslim, like that, yeah. Not bad Muslim. Left Islam. Left Islam, Murtad.
It's alright. I know people are taking it tonight.
An Arabic scholar.
Here's the Quran for you. Provide the verse for me.
Why you cut the Quran?
This is not the book of God. Show me the verse. Provide the verse from the Quran that people have free will to choose.
Okay, if you leave Islam, that's it. You left Islam.
Is that what Allah says?
Yes. If you leave Islam, you're kafir.
What happened to the Kafirs?
They
go to
Canada.
Wait, what?
Deliver slap.
What's your question? What's your question?
Yeah, without your head on.
Yeah, without your head.
Without your head.
Please.
What is your question?
It's a criminal offence.
Apostasy is a criminal offence in 16 countries throughout the Middle East.
They
go to Canada.
If you are thinking it is alright to make a joke about someone's mind, I'm not joking. You're serious.
Me?
About
your head and
you're serious.
Your head's off.
No, because you're a joke. That's why we're joking with you.
Shall we go to the hadith?
Yes.
Shall we go to the hadith? You see, he's not going to go to the hadith.
You become a Zab. You go to Canada.
You're Quran only. Quran only.
Oh,
yes, you become a kafir.
You can afford to Canada.
I don't know. Because me, I don't read. But I'm going to tell you, it's too cool.
No, no, this is for in the
culture. It's very cool. Okay, you read for us. I don't know.
I read.
If you leave Islam, you go to Canada.
It is as they did.
Simple as that.
Go to
where you from? Where you from? Philippines. Go to Philippines.
Liar,
you're crazy. Liar.
So you want me to kill you?
Allah.
You speak rubbish.
Allah doesn't laugh at it.
Why you don't come here and talk about your Bible?
Why you don't like it?
Why you don't talk about your nice things in your Bible?
In Quran said,
why you don't come here and invite people to be Christians? This woman complains to attack Islam. This woman takes money every week to attack Islam.
How much they pay you for this?
Yeah.
How much you get paid for this? In Quran said, if you kill one person, it's like you kill everybody.
Exactly.
Yes. And that's what Quran said.
Ask her what the Christian did in Serbia. Ask her what the Christian did in Serbia. And the Kosovo. They killed millions. The Christian killed millions in Kosovo.
We love you.
You are identifying yourself since when
you are taking her serious. She don't know what she talk about anyway. She's not qualified to talk about Islam. She can't talk Arab.
Listen, Quran, Quran is having
you need to study Arabic before you talk
about Islam. It's made by God.
La ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah.
Jesus was a messenger.
So, you are agreeing with the Quran and you think people who are literally close to
no, they go to Canada.
We don't
no.
believe that.
They
so
go
they
to Canada.
Don't kill Ahl-Kitab. Ahl Kitab means Christians,
exactly.
Jews,
and that's what any Muslim believes. That's what any Muslim believes.
You are not people in the book.
I
respect you. Marry them.
Marry a Muslim.
Marry a
prophet. Married Christian.
I should marry you.
Our prophet married Christian.
I should marry you because you're Christian.
Because you are.
Why do you want reference? I'm a historian.
If we're not ordered to kill a Muslim, so we're gonna call Muslim who left, or we're gonna talk to him nice.
Well,
it's not, no. You don't understand. I understand.
Go to Canada.
we order to advise them. We order who leave Islam. Who leave Islam. Who leave Islam. We order to talk nice to him.
Don't believe ISIS or Taliban.
Liar! 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 You get paid about what you say. You have no balance. You can't talk Arabic. You can't talk Arabic. Study Arabic. Study Arabic. Muhammad
Rasulullah. Another liar. The boss is here, the boss.
You see, we Muslim and we laugh with you. Know what happens? You see, we Muslim and you're attacking us, attacking our religion. They're going to get up and we have no problem about what you say.
You clearly do, don't you?
No, no, no. Do you understand Arabic to explain to me my Quran? Do you understand Arabic?
You don't need to understand. You don't need to understand Arabic.
Do not kill the people of the book.
That's Islam.
Answer here.
That's true.
Answer here.
There's contradiction in your book.
Exactly. Listen to him.
But you are the people of the book. We shouldn't kill you.
يا زبالة النسوان يا وايف أم جميل يا مرات أبو لهب يا وسخة You rubbish women.
You're brave.
Anyway, we doing this with this woman because this woman she not qualified to talk about Islam.
لا إله إلا الله.
Shame.
لا إله إلا الله.
Shame.
لا اله الا الله.
نرجع ورا خط.
لا طبي يا رامي.
نرجع ورا خط عم جابر بيتكلم معاه.
لا طبي يا رامي. لا اله الا الله.
That's all they got. That's all they got. That's
all they got.
I told Jamal to the rescue. Because you Roman don't know what you're talking about. That's why we're joking. That's why we love you. This woman never answered any question we asked her. This woman never talked about her Christianity. Never talked about her Bible. This woman always coming talking about Islam, about our prophet. Because we are a strong religion. Because we are a good religion. Listen, there is people worship.
Let me ask you a question.
There is people worshiping cows.
Let me ask you a question. The Bible that she reads, does it talk about Islam? The Bible she reads, does it talk about Islam? Your Quran talks about her beliefs. So
therefore, let me ask.
Let me tell you something. If your Quran attacks her belief, she has the right to defend her belief. She doesn't have to talk about Christianity. She can defend her faith any way she wants.
How she defends? How she defends by attacking Islam? Or by showing that her belief is right?
No. Because if someone attacks you, you can attack the faith back.
So why she not believe that her belief is good?
It's not your criteria.
Why she not believe in that? Why she not believe that her belief is good?
Because if your book attacks her faith, she has the.
We're not attacking. My book asking me to respect my belief. My neighbor is Christian. I grew up with Christian in Egypt, and I am Muslim.
If she believes,
I have no problem with any Christian.
Yeah, but if your book mentions Christianity and says that they fabricate meaning to Jesus, that's called slandering. Therefore, she's making a lie. Therefore, that means you're making a slander against her.
If you're religious, if you're Christian, religious, loving your deen, and you come to place like that, you should do da'wah to your religion. You should invite people to be Christian. But you don't do that.
Wait. Let me tell you.
Okay. So you're attacking people worshiping the same God like you. But you don't attack people worshiping cows, worshiping animals.
This is corner. No one can dictate to anyone else what they want to come and talk about.
You can't talk anything.
If someone wants to talk about capitalism, no one can come and say, talk about communism. If they want to talk about Islam, they can talk about Islam.
Who don't have any religion.
Speaker's corner, someone can talk about whatever they want. It's not down to anyone else to say, you can come to Speaker's corner and talk about this. If they want to talk about my faith, they can do it. If someone talks about Buddhism and they're not a Buddhist, that's what up to their opinion. But this is what Speaker's Corner is about.
And I have the right also to defend my religion, innit? Because all the time you're attacking me, so I have the right.
But you can't come
and
here.
And my way is any Muslim did this now, he defending his religion like that.
That's fine.
Because we don't order to fight with you.
Even if you cast my God
in my religion, I have to leave you, you know that?
Okay.
Okay, I have to just stop talking with you, that's it.
That's fine.
Yeah,
but what I'm saying to you is this. People cannot come to Speaker's Corner and dictate what other people speak about, even if it goes against your belief.
I just want to understand. Let me finish my point.
People come and say, for example, DCCIs, they talk about Islam and not enough about Christianity. If your faith is attacking their faith, they have every single right to come and attack what they believe is attacking them. No one can come and say, you don't come. You have to raise your
voice. Islam ordered me to respect the Christian.
Exactly.
That's your lie. You can't believe that.
Do not lie to us. We're not as gullible as your audience. Surah 9:29-9:31. Tell Allah says, destroy the Christians.
Can you speak Arabic to talk about Quran?
I don't need to.
Are you qualified? Can you speak Arabic? You can't. You have no right to talk about Arabic.
I have a right to talk about whatever.
You have the right, but you are not.
I am not.
You don't know that. You don't have the right.
I am not demi-status.
Any Christian studied Arabic, the Quran says in 9:29, 9:31, destroy the Christians and the Jews.
Liar.
That is the truth.
Liar.
Liar. What?
I am God said.
Any Muslim
preaching
you're a liar.
Liar. You're lying.
He's using what they call
Kadir, here, bro.
And he,
you're lying.
He has no honor or respect for himself.
Wallahi, you're lying
about the truth. Allah says, may.
That's what he told you. That's what he told you.
So what is the context? Where did you get that in the Bible? Where in the Bible does it say love thy neighbor?
You don't know, but you're quoting it.
Listen,
so there we go.
Listen.
That's the Islam of ignorance.
What's the Christian in Serbia? What's the Christian in Serbia and Kosovo?
What?
They killed the million.
How?
They killed the million.
That's what you ordered. What is Serbia?
Oh, I've held him to account and he's embarrassed because he knows he cannot lie to me. And I will not be strong armed with
you. I can't take you serious because you don't know Arabic.
I don't take you serious.
You don't know Arabic.
Because you don't know what you're talking about.
We don't care. Thank you very much.
A woman is helping him. So this is the Islamic cowardice.
Yeah.
That's why Muhammad,
when he was not like you attack. And my religion is left our woman. Not like your religion.
So this is a coward. A woman has to rescue him from the reality of a conversation.
No, no, because you're not qualified to
talk to me.
Because you're not qualified to talk about Quran. Because you don't know what the meaning of Arabic.
I don't need to know the meaning of Arabic.
You have to know what is the meaning of Arabic.
No. So
now
you've
heard. Talking about something you don't know.
So the Quran in English are inaccurate. You heard it from a Muslim's mouth. He has shown you that the dialogue of the Quran cannot be understood in English. So if you read a Sahih International, Yusuf Ali, a Muslim that says he's been to an Islamic school, has confirmed that unless you speak the Quran in Arabic, you're learning nothing.
Levels have a conversation. We don't talk to peasants.
Peasants. So this is someone calling me a peasant when I'm actually a glad.
You called him a glad.
And I'm like Satan.
And you're blaming her.
I'm going to show you the evidence. I like this guy. They put themselves deeper in the water because of their ignorance and uneducated beliefs.
You are uneducated.
I am going to prove.
Can a woman be an imam in Islam? Can a woman be an imam?
Oh, well done. Look at the timing. They walked into a trap when the fake pagan god Allah, whose carved stone is full of the menstrual blood of women,
what about when the
on by the pagan?
What about when the woman is going to be paid for his labels?
I love this.
Yeah, they, but look at the face.
Epic fail.
Arabic.
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 No, no, no.
Arabic. Jealousy doesn't have that problem.
Okay, so now repeat this now.
So you have to understand here because one word
is I made a mistake about Allah being Satan. So this is for the international audience. For those that have an educated mind and led to listen. Sahih al-Bukhari, 1125.
Sahih al-Bukhari is not Quran.
Hold on.
It's not orders from God. It's someone who wrote it. It's
not
someone
Quran.
Who wrote it. He can
Quran.
Do mistakes.
So now,
he's the prophet.
So now,
he's human like me and you. Okay, he can do his mistakes.
I'm going to talk. Another epic fail from this guy. This is a hadith with the Quran verse inside it.
No. There is no hadith Quran verse inside it. Quran is the orders of Allah. Hadith is orders.
This man has thus got no knowledge. So now I'm going to read it. Gabriel did not come to the prophet for some time. And so one of the Quraysh women said, his Satan has deserted him. So came the divine revelation. Now read the Quran, 93:1-3. By the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord Muhammad has neither forsaken nor hated you. So this is the confirmation Allah is Satan.
Okay.
And we'll go into more. Surah
53:1-23. I'm gonna explain it to you because you can't
Arabic. I don't need your explanation. Sorry.
So you don't understand?
This is my monologue.
Allah, you speak Arabic.
You're like machines.
Allah,
you're like
machines.
You
repeat
it. You repeat it.
That's what our followers has asked. Allah only speaks Arabic.
No, expose yourself more. Expose yourself.
Bring the Quran. What language you have?
What language
you
have? No. He said you don't want to talk to
me. And the Quran came by Arab.
That's your
language.
Sorry.
Allah is only Arabic.
No. To the whole world.
So, Allah can speak any language.
No, not even.
Yes, sure.
What we're going to do? So to Surah 53. We're going to prove Muhammad's Lord is Jibril. And we're going to provide the hadith.
Because what verse?
I'm going to
so now Quran. I'm trying to answer him by Arabic. And he don't want to say the verse.
Because
you know you're going to be embarrassed. What verse is that?
Show me
me one verse. Tell me one verse.
You're gonna anger me now.
Stick around. Stick around.
You need to calm down. This guy's getting hysterical. First he said I was wrong. Show me the Bukhari. Show my man. I showed him the Quran.
I am a
chill.
Sahih Bukhari. Calm my man.
Relax. Has anyone got Coca-Cola so this guy can drink? He's a bit too high pressure. Too much coffee in the morning is not good for you. So now,
bro, you make a joke, so you want to talk.
Yeah, because I don't take it seriously. You want to talk, yeah?
You want to talk, yeah?
So now, I'm going to read the so-called Noble Quran.
Okay?
Yeah. Now, the statement we made is that, and I would like Brother Hudson to read it again. So we're going to do it in order, so that people are educated to the truth of this religion.
You want
to
make
the religion of Satan.
Do you want to make my
Sorry.
Let's get this
read. But the people have to understand that.
Narrated Jubayr bin Abdullah. Gabriel did not come to the Prophet for some time, and so one of the Quraysh women said he Satan had deserted him. So came the divine revelation. Thus,
and this is the Quran. Yeah, this is the Quran.
By the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord, O Muhammad, has neither forsaken you nor hated you.
That is the Quran.
So
now,
yes, I know the verse. Go on. What else?
No, no. Now we're going to go to the Quran. Yeah, so some of the people will say that the Quran. Brother, let's not get them distracted. Now, some people say that Muhammad's Lord is not Gabriel. So we'll go into the. Which translation? Sahih International. And we're going to go into an hadith that will show you the more confusion. When Muslims talk about Tawheed, we believe in one God, but Tawheed means unification. And if you know that the Kaaba stone is one God because it's going to have eyes and ears one day and do a testimony, the Quran is eternal, that makes it a second God. Hold on, this is my narrative.
No, don't
interrupt. Chill. Okay, go on. Patience is a good virtue.
Why do you have to divert?
Patience is a virtue. I'm explaining my point for the audience. This is unfortunately.
Yes, well, the audience here, explain
now. No, you are not in dialogue with me. No, you just come in.
Forget this.
So, and Jibril was the one that brought the revelation. So now we'll go into why Jibril is the third God, the unholy trinity of the Quran. By the star when it descends, your companion has not strayed nor is he erred, nor does he speak of his own inclination. It is but a revelation revealed, taught to him by one of intense strength, Gabriel. One of soundness and rose to his true form, which, while he was in the higher part of the horizon, then he approached and descended, and was at a distance of 2 bow lengths or nearer, and he revealed to his servant. So the servant of Gabriel is Muhammad. That is one epic fail.
You did read it properly.
Hold on, you did read it properly. What he revealed?
No, you didn't read it properly.
Can you read it properly?
Gabriel is a messenger.
Jibril sitting on the throne of Allah. We're going to, like I said, these guys are jumping ahead of the time. They don't know what we're trying to make. So don't make the point. After I finish this, we'll go to that. So, and he revealed to his servant. So Jibril's revealed to his servant. What he revealed? Hold on, sir. Who revealed? And he suddenly saw him in another descent at the lottery. So that's the Lord of Muhammad coming twice to revelation. Near it was a garden refuge paradise. When it was covered, the lottery that covered it. Now we get to the satanic verses, because this is a word of Allah, and Allah speaking for Satan's behalf. And that it is he that destroyed the Lord of Sirius, and he destroyed the first people, and the Talmud. Wait, sorry. I missed a page. Yeah. Right. This is the first mistake I made today.
No, but I'm human.
No,
by the way, I know the verse.
I don't care whether you know the verse. Okay, I'm talking about my point. You're not a mind reader.
I know your point.
You're not a mind
reader. I know your point
because you don't know my point. The sight of the prophet did not swerve, nor did it transgress. He certainly saw the greatest of signs of his Lord. So have you considered Alat, Al-Uzza, and Manat the third, another one? This is a male and female. So now we have Satan declaring Satan's words. So
wait, hold on.
Complete the verse. I dare you to complete.
He can't complete. Let him complete. No. Let him complete
my narrative.
Let him complete.
Now I will complete the narrative. So now I go to Sahih. Sahih Muslim will provide you the references so that you put this up. Sahih Muslim 161D. And I won't read the whole of it, but this is when Muhammad got his revelation. I was again called and I looked, but I saw nothing, which an Arabic scholar has confirmed.
No, it's not true.
I saw Gabriel, peace be upon him. So why is Jibril or Gabriel or whatever sitting on the throne of Allah.
That's not the throne. And that is not a throne. It's not a throne. It's not a throne. He's a liar.
What is it? What is it? What is it?
What did he say?
Oh, this gentleman, I like you. He's the one that said Allah is not our God. This is the man, remember? Yeah, 109. Surah 109. Kill him on camera. You're a good man. I respect you. Yeah. There you go. That's what I want. Thank you, sir.
Do you agree with him?
I respect you for your honesty.
What do you want him to read? He wants him.
Can you put the camera here where your friend stopped? What did he say here? The male and the female, yeah? Then this is an unjust division.
Yeah, go on.
They are not but names you have named.
Go on.
Okay.
Make your point.
Who's in here, Manat al Izzah? Who's glorifying them?
I'm not concerned.
Who's glorifying them?
Hold on, sir.
Who's glorifying them?
Let me answer you.
Yeah.
Do you want an answer?
Yes, an answer.
My script was to show that the Lord of Muhammad, one of the gods you worship, is Jibril, because he's sitting on the throne of Allah.
Where's the throne?
Now read the hadith. I'm going to give you this.
Should I read it? Should I read it out? From the green, yeah? I was again called, and I looked about but saw nothing. I was called again and raised my head. And there on the throne in the open atmosphere, he, i.e. Gabriel, peace be upon him, was sitting. I began to tremble on account of fear. Sitting. Where would they sit
in? Open atmosphere. Open atmosphere.
So what are you saying that means?
Open atmosphere.
So what is it a throne or is it not?
Is there only one throne in the world?
No, my friend. Hold on.
Is there only one throne?
Hold on, let's reason. Is it a throne or is it not? Make your point. Right, so, and who's sitting on it?
And that's what he's saying.
This is not the throne of God.
Oh, so there's more than one throne.
No. Is there only one throne in the world?
Okay, well, you explain to me.
Hold on one second. Now, if I sit on the throne here.
Sorry, my friend.
If you sit on the throne here.
You're a man. It doesn't mean
no, hold on. Hold on. How many thrones? Let's flash this out. How many thrones are there? Is there only one throne? Thrones
in the world?
Does God have a throne and does he sit on it?
No, he doesn't sit on it.
Okay, where is God and what's the relationship with Allah and his throne? What's the relationship with Allah and his throne? Does Allah have a throne or not and does he sit on it?
No, it's not for him to sit on it. No.
So what is the throne and Allah? What is the relationship? My friend, it's not what it says here. My friend, you're making this up.
Okay.
Come on.
Hold on.
My friend, you're making this up.
How did you know this is the throne of God, by the way?
This guy said Allah does
not have a
throne.
My friend, didn't you see what I read?
And they're on a throne.
Yeah?
Here, by the way, they've added the... On a throne.
Yeah, okay, so, let me ask you then. Who's sitting on the throne?
One second. Now, if I say to you, I saw you sitting on the throne, does that mean you're sitting
on the throne? No, my friend, you're not comparing like with like. I'm asking you about this particular context.
Okay, where's the throne of God? Where's the throne of God?
Hold on, my friend, hold on. You're saying he's wrong, and now this is your chance to prove him wrong.
Yeah, exactly.
You've got to do intentionally.
Where does it say the throne of God here?
My friend.
Where does it say the throne of God?
Oh, so Jibril sits on the throne as well. Is that what you're saying? Thank you. So now he's proved my point. Islam has many gods. The Kaaba is one god. This is your words. Jibril has a throne. Allah has a throne. And the Kaaba stone has its own temple.
Hold on. We're not talking about a human throne, like a king or Jibril. We're talking about a heavenly throne, of a deity.
Stop. As another Muslim claim that
throne is this?
My friend, you keep asking the same question.
What's the throne? What's the throne of this?
I'm asking you, in order to answer that question, you have to answer me this. Does God have a throne and is there more than one throne?
There is more than one throne. Yeah, there is more than one throne.
Yeah, there's more than one god. You have more than one god.
There's more than one throne.
No, what is it? Throne per God?
My friend, you're not very...
No, hold on. Is it throne per God?
I'm asking a very simple question. I'm not accusing you. I'm asking a question.
That's why I'm asking you, because you seem you're surprised.
No.
Here, this brother here, read the word throne.
So we've established then that there is more than one throne and because that Allah is not the only one that has a throne.
There's 100,000 thrones in the world.
Who's sitting on them?
In the throne. Everyone sits on his own throne.
So God is not the only one.
Doesn't Elizabeth sit on her throne?
We're not talking about humans.
No.
My friend.
Come on.
What is
it?
You can't. You're on an epic fail. This doesn't work. You're making yourself. Remember, you're on camera.
We're not talking about a human king or queen. We're talking about deity.
Okay. Hold on. Does angels sit on thrones?
No.
I'm asking you.
Yes.
Oh.
What's
the problem? In Islam.
Okay.
What's the problem?
Asking for evidence. Where's the evidence? Show me a problem. Show me a story. No. Not this one. No. Show it in the Quran.
It doesn't have to be in there.
No, it has to. That's the Quran. That's the word.
How do you know anything without that? According to your faith.
No. It's the word of Allah. Show us there.
The Quran here show you everything?
Yes.
Everything that's essential, yes. It should be.
Is it essential to you know, to know how many phones the
No. What is essential is that whether or not God is the only one that sits on a throne.
Why does he need to sit?
My friend.
Hold on. Why does the your God need to sit on the throne?
Right, I'm going
to
answer.
Why does he need to sit on the throne?
Because of what's going on here.
No, leave that. Why does your God have to sit on the throne?
This is the context. I can't leave it. This is what we're dealing with. This is what he's dealing with.
Okay.
My friend, what I'm saying is,
your brother just said now here that this is the throne of God.
Let's get right. Hold on, sir. Hold on, sir.
That's why we're asking whose throne is it?
Can I just my initial trajectory on this conversation was very simple.
Yeah.
I said that Islam has more than one God. Said it's a lie.
Yeah.
I mentioned that the God of Muhammad, let's go back for everybody to get this.
Go step by step.
So that refresh your brain so it might help you to actually make a meaningful argument that's not going to make you come across really, really absurd to the public.
Your argument is really useless.
Because your mind is sitting on the throne, and that means it's the throne of God, that means he's God.
That was not my argument. You are speaking for me.
What is the throne?
I will start from the beginning.
You're not answering. You're saying that it's not a throne. I'm saying, what throne is it then? And you're not answering that question. Any throne is good.
By the way, in the Arabic,
the Arabic translation is
kursi, not arsh.
I'll start again.
Yeah, I know Arabic.
I'll start again.
You don't.
What
you
I mentioned.
I do. You don't. I'm Arab. You don't know Arabic. Okay, bring the hadith in Arabic.
You don't know
Arabic.
Step by step.
I've got the hadith in Arabic. She's Arab.
Okay. Show me. Does it say arsh or kursi?
I will bring it in Arabic.
No, what does it say? Arsh or kursi?
When a man makes a claim against my integrity and my
kursi,
now he's
your Christian friend is trying to change. Even your translation is wrong.
So I will go back to where I started.
Your translation is wrong.
Because this guy's he's trying takia and it's not really working. I'll start again. Gabriel did not come to the Prophet for some time. So one of the Quraysh women said, "Is Satan has deserted him?" So came the divine revelation. And this is the Quran. By the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord, O Muhammad, has not forsaken nor forgotten. So I said that one of the lords of Islam is Gabriel. So then I referred to a second hadith, which is Sahih Muslim 161d. I was called again and I looked and I saw nothing. I was called again and raised my head. And on the throne in the open atmosphere, if you look at the Arabic, it actually says in heaven, Gabriel, peace be upon him, was sitting. I began to tremble on account of fear. I came to Khadija and she said, "Wrap me up, wrap me up." My point was that, why is Gabriel sitting on the throne?
Okay,
Gabriel, hold on, I'm not finished. No, because I'm going to the
Quran. Now, the word, let him bring the Arabic word first.
To prove my point, that Gabriel was the Lord of Muhammad. I went to Surah 53, verses 1-18. And it went like this: by the star when it descends, your companion Muhammad has not strayed or erred, nor does he speak for his inclination. It is not by revelation revealed, taught to him by one of intense strength, that is Gabriel, one of the soundless and the rose is true form. While he was in the higher part of the horizon, then he approached and descended from the throne, which is, this is the context of what I've been given.
Where's Jibreel?
And
where's Jibreel?
Was at the distance of 2 bar lengths or nearer, and he revealed to his servant. So now the Quran quickly says that the servant of Jibreel is Muhammad.
No, it's not.
That is the Quran.
No, it did say
Sahih International.
So what's it mean?
What did he say then?
Maybe he knows. But he's an honest Muslim.
This is the man that said that Allah is not the God we worship. علمه شديد القوى ذو مرة فاستوى وهو بالآفاق الأعلى ثم دنا فتدلى فكان قبى قوس أو أدنى
فأوحى إلى عبده ما أوحى.
You mix it. Sorry, sir. What verse did you stop at?
It's a stop at 10.
No, continue.
Continue until
we didn't get to 10. We went further than
10.
Go to
23.
أفتمارونه على ما يرى ولقد رآه نزلة أخرى عند سدرة المنتهى عندها جنة المأوى إذ يخشى السدرة ما يخشى ما زاغ البصر وما طغى لقد رأى من آيات ربه لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى.
Which verse did you stop at?
Stop at 19.
No, no,
go
to
23.
Go to 23.
Come on, come on. 23,
go to 24. They don't want
24. Yeah. Well, go to 30. It doesn't matter. Yeah, yeah. You're still.
Why are you stopping at 23?
No, 23 is actually the verse that you told us to stop at.
إن هي إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان إن يتبعون إلا الظن وما تهوى الأنفس ولقد جاءهم من ربهم الهدى أما الإنسان ما تمنى فلله الآخرة والأولى
30, 35
سورة النجم.
Okay, I do not hear Alat Al-Uzza or Manat in his English translation. So we're gonna have to get an Arabic speaker to confirm it.
أفرأيتم اللات
والمنات الثلاث. You had dialogue, but you didn't want to really talk like a gentleman. So I dismissed
me. Tell us what you had time to respond directly.
What I have more, I have respect for you because you were the one of the, you're the Muslim when I quoted Surah 109 that said the God of Islam is not the God of the Bible, and that is what I wanted, that is my mission here, to prove that the God of Islam is not the God of the Bible, and you prove that.
We don't worship Jesus.
We don't, well there you had it from Israel. They worship Muhammad.
No, no, we don't.
This is why, no, they were called Muhammadians for centuries. Now he's changed his mind. He's changed his mind. I always make them slip up because liars will always get caught out. Liars always get caught out.
Specifically, I don't worship Jesus. I don't worship Muhammad. Hey,
and that is Antichrist. That is Antichrist. So,
okay. Hey, let's prove that. Okay, so are we done with it?
No, no, show us the Arabic text.
You can't get away with it.
No, he runs away. Yeah, yeah.
What do you want to get?
But did you see? Did you see the beauty? And I can say this is from Allah. But you cannot go back to the Bible. You're going to say, there's 200 after Jesus.
No, no, let's do with worship. Who do you worship? So on the day of judgment, the Kaaba stone is going to have ears and eyes. And it's going to testify on your behalf. Is that true?
I don't know about the hadith.
You don't know about the hadith. So why do you kiss the Kaaba stone? Because it's the right hand of Allah. That is what we are under interpretation.
We kiss the Kaaba because we saw our Prophet kissing it.
Okay,
and we know it's a stone.
You know it's a stone.
We know it's a stone.
Okay.
We don't worship a Kaaba.
So are you aware of that hadith that says we used to worship stones, and when we found a new or better stone, we'll milk sheep over it and then worship that new stone? That was the traditions of the Arabs beforehand. That's the same here.
They were Arab pagans.
So how come you're doing the same rituals as the Arab pagans?
No, we don't.
This is what's been confirmed by the scholars. Sorry, sir.
I'm not going to play
the hadith can come out. This is not something I'm making up. I can't call it off because I didn't prepare. The script I had was different.
Come back next week, we'll discuss it then.
I don't really want to discuss paganism because I don't see the... My view is,
What's wrong with paganism?
Is against the God of the Bible. The God of the Bible in Leviticus 26:1 says do not bow to stones or worship it. That is what the Bible tells us. I can try to
look at it. Listen.
So you guys are breaking the laws of Moses.
If you ask the Arab pagans what you worship it,
they don't exist anymore.
I'm telling you what it is, you can search it. They said we worship in this stone. Not because we know it's God. It's just a mediator between us and God. That's what you worship.
It's a mediator, the stone.
Mediator.
So when you kiss the carved stone, how does the carved stone take your sins if it's not real?
I'm going to ask you a question.
How does the stone?
When you worship in Jesus.
No.
When you worship in Jesus.
I'll pray to God. gospel. Trust me, I'm an evangelist. I'm here to preach the gospel. And I can make sure that you love the gospel. But what I want to say is that you said that the stone is because Muhammad kissed it. But we're saying that you guys do the Hajj to kiss that stone to absorb your sin. So if the stone is not living and it's nothing real, how does the stone absorb your sin? Now explain.
That's paganism.
Veneration of any object is called paganism. That is what you need an English dictionary to understand.
If I kiss my father's hand, am I worshipping my father?
No. If you kiss a stone to take away your sin, that is paganism. That is. You know it.
It's a large audience can see us, and I want people to go on the search that the Muslim don't worship stones.
What is that thing about kissing the stone?
No, the kissing the stone, we saw our prophet doing it, and we're doing it. We're just following it. We're the follower of Muhammad.
That's from heaven.
But we don't worship.
You don't worship. But doesn't the Kaaba stone come to life and testify on the day of judgment? It does come to life. It has ears. It's going to testify. That is what the Quranic narrative. This is very easy
brother,
to find
I
out.
I mean, the stone and I kiss the stone.
Of course, the stone is dead. I know that. So,
and the stone never
on judgment day, the stone, the Kaaba stone, will testify on behalf of Muslims. It's going to have ears and eyes. That is the truth. I'm not making this up. I don't know, because the Kaaba stone is supposed to be the right hand of Allah. Muslims worship more than one God. Tawheed means unification. So Jibril is on the throne of Allah, one God. Allah is another God. And the Kaaba stone is another God. They are polytheists.
Brother, common sense.
You've got more gods.
Common sense.
And Muhammad is the fourth, because Allah prays to Muhammad.
Allah prays to Muhammad.
Allah prays
to Muhammad. Take your hijab.
Let me ask you. Now we can talk about Jesus.
No, listen.
We all love Jesus.
So we are worshiping God, Allah, and Allah, He knows everything.
The moon God, God knows everything.
He knows we worship different gods.
God knows everything, right?
I don't think Allah does, because Allah says meteorites.
God to you, He knows everything.
Yeah, but not your God. Allah doesn't know anything.
God knows everything.
I have more brains than Allah.
To be witness on me.
I have more brains than Allah. Sorry, Allah says that women are sperm in the backbone of their ribs. I cannot take that God seriously. Allah says meteorites are shooting stars to stop shaitans from going to heaven. That is what the Quran says. Allah says in the Quran that the earth is flat and there's seven flat earths.
It's flat. Definitely flat.
So I cannot believe Allah is God. I have no brain. NASA's debunked.
Listen. No. I can challenge him.
Are you ready to talk about Jesus?
I can challenge him. He showed me in the Quran that the earth is flat. But I can show him in the Bible.
It's flat.
You can show me in the Bible the earth is flat.
It's flat.
Show me in the Bible.
Yeah. It's about the firmament and that lot, isn't it?
This is another epic fail. I'll show you in the Bible.
It's definitely flat.
In the Bible, Joel, the earth is circle.
It doesn't exist.
So give us a reference to fact check.
Isaiah 42. The circle of the earth.
Sorry? Firmament.
Yeah, 42.
Firmament. It's flat, isn't it? It's flat.
Isaiah 42. I've got the stuff on the flat earth in the Quran. Is it in that one?
I don't know if you got it.
I forgot to bring it. I didn't come prepared.
Let me put anything.
So basically, the famous Omar. He's still here. I can't believe he's still here.
Still here.
Haven't threatened no one yet. Come on, Omar. You've got a beautiful sunset behind you. Look at that. Omar is.
Every time I'm asking you now, every time I come with him, with the Bible, which you tell me to go away and go on the Arabic. Do you remember the verse? 10 to 12. 40 or 41, if it's not 40 or 41, from about verse 10.
Can I respond now?
Yes, respond.
I like being flat.
brilliant. Flat Earth is the best conspiracy in the whole lot. It's just, if honestly, when you start reading it, it's like
Isaiah 11 things
prove the Earth flat. Your brain does a weird thing to your head.
Isaiah 11:12, it says that the Earth has four corners.
It's not only flat.
Does anyone have Google on them now?
It's a table.
Isaiah 42, circle of the Earth. Isaiah, I'm just looking for the verse and I don't want to waste the...
You're saying wrong. Because you're the mother tongue. The translation might not be the exact translation. It could mean different.
Excuse me, you said this is an Isaiah, it's in Luke, and it says Earth have four corners.
No, the corners of the Earth, okay. Everyone uses
it. It's a table to me.
I think we're doing a while.
The brother over there said it doesn't exist. Isaiah, look.
Wicked.
It's not coming up. Come on.
It says the Earth has four corners.
No, it says the four corners of the Earth. That's an allegory.
What makes it a triangle?
We are sitting on one.
Sorry?
Why are we lying about what here? What am I lying about?
The world, yeah. I think in the chapter of Job. All right, you know what? I don't want to get caught up into this circle of the earth thing. But if it's... I know in Job, the Lord rebukes Job at one point. And he says that, who made the firmaments and the circle of the earth? And it's also in Isaiah, but I can't just seem to find it. But the narrative, what we tried to produce before, and I want to come into conclusion on this, because this is how the Muslims are. They sneak away. They find something to detract them. He talked about the four corners of the earth, but that is an English kind of metaphor. But this brother, I'd like to introduce him. It's been a while. I met him a long time ago in Speaker's Corner, and this is the importance of our mission. He was trying to preach the gospel, but he was not a born-again Christian. And he was really trying to stand up for Christ because he was disappointed with how the Muslims... I came and gave him advice for Sister Betty. Please speak for yourself. I don't like...
Yeah, in a nutshell, well, I actually brought my son here. You didn't see him, but I brought my son here because I think it's important to be with fellow Christians and just try and get some answers, really, to questions. And I was surrounded by Muslims and they were asking me questions and I wasn't knowledge enough to give them sufficient answers. And I was trying to find the answers, but I was struggling a bit. And he sort of saw me. I don't know if he saw me struggling or if he saw me. He saw me and came to me and just said, look, just read your Bible. Really up your game. So I took that, and that day I actually did nothing. You know, as a struggling Christian, I found something else to sort of bypass the time, but it really played on my mind. I just wanted to say thank you. And every day I just, even if you read a page, two pages, you don't have to do nothing major, just try to dissect it slowly and build up, and you know, you help me a lot. And
no, God bless.
The quest continues. Yes,
the quest continues.
Definitely.
What we are trying to do as Christians, I cannot enforce my religion on you. It's faith. It's my faith will justify. Hebrews chapter 11 or 12, if I'm correct. But this is a scripture of what brings us our belief. I use the King James Version, which is a best translation from Greek that I'll take off. I'll not say look at all the other translations, unless you want to be a Berean and understand the greater context, and you do not follow the biblical account to the T. Please do not come here and try and get into polemics and apologetics with Muslims. If you're going to tackle a Muslim on the Quran, make sure you've been like me that spent 10 years and lived under Sharia law and come from the Sahara, from an Islamic... A lot of Christians here make this mistake. They think they understand Islam. Islam is not a religion. If you look at the book, it's called Dawah in the West. The head scholar says Islam is not a religion, it's a deen, a way of life. I've lived under Islam. I have an Islamic name. I'm called Yaqub. My brother's called Ibrahim. I understand Islam. They are called Muhammadians. In our area, in the old days, there were Isawites, the followers of Prophet Isa and the prophets of Muhammad, and they were called Muhammadians. That is the historical narrative of Islam. To understand this, you must come from a culture that has lived with Muslims for 1,000 years, and the traditions are kept down. When you get the tradition of Hadith, that is the old ancient tradition that is passed on in the Saharan people. So we have a tradition of Hadith that comes and tells me what my ancestors did. And now we're putting them on the websites, on YouTube and etc. So please understand the deen of Islam, the five pillars they live on. If you go and start quoting the Quran, they don't read the Quran. most of them don't know Arabic. All they know is how to do 5 daily prayers, do zakat, do hajj, and pilgrimage, and what their parents taught them. That is the real Islam. So don't be hard on the Muslims. Understand the Bible. Bring the gospel of salvation, that Jesus Christ is God manifest in the flesh, who died on the cross, and whose blood paid on the cross pays for our sins. And if you do not acknowledge that, then if you die, you are going to the eternal damnation, eternal separation from God. That is the importance of our message. Sorry, we are not here to get caught up in whether you should hit a woman, or whether you should go to toilets squatting like a woman even though you're a man, or whether we should wear women's clothes to receive divine revelations, or we should wear makeup like Muhammad. No, that is unimportant. The message is eternal salvation, because when you die, you'll be held to account by our Lord and Savior. Jesus said, all judgment has been passed on to me from the Father. Jesus is God in the flesh. That's what the Son of God means. It doesn't mean that there's a separate God. That is the God of the Quran that believes that Mary, Jesus, and Allah are three gods. The God of the Quran is stupid. If you want to be as ignorant as he is and doesn't even understand what Christianity is, then you'll go to eternal fire. A lot of Muslims might find me a bit aggressive. There's a pride in Islam. Don't be proud of stupidity. Drop your pride and read. Get knowledge. Ignorance is a disease. And the only way you can treat the disease of ignorance is by education. This is what you need to learn. God bless all the audience. And thank you, sir, for your testimony. Amen.